Let me show you a simple and effective way to add beautiful sun rays to an image using free Snapseed app. This is more easier way to add sun rays compared to my other videos I had shown before. This is Nagesh and welcome to Navidips. I have this image of a man standing on the edge of a cliff. The subject doesn't have a ton of detail, but that's not really a big deal since we are aiming for more of an atmospheric ambient vibe. The file is a raw DNG which gives us a bit more flexibility, but honestly you can still get great results with the JPEG too, so no worries there. Once you have imported the DNG into Snapseed, you will notice there's a dedicated develop menu that pops up, which is where we will start fine-tuning the image to bring out the look we are going for. We are going to start by flattening the image a little to create a more balanced look. First, we'll reduce the highlights, which will help bring back details in the brighter areas that might be a bit overexposed. Similarly, we'll increase the shadows to pull out more details from the darker parts of the image. After that, I will bump up the contrast and structure, which will not only sharpen things up a bit, but also add more depth and texture to the overall scene. These adjustments will really start to give the image that ambient feel we are going for. Next, we'll focus on brightening just the subject to make him stand out more against the ambient background. Instead of increasing brightness across the whole image, we'll use the curves tool to add global brightness. Once that's done, we'll switch to the masking screen. Using the brush tool at 100% opacity, I'll carefully apply the brightness adjustment only to the subject by brushing directly over him. Zooming in to be more precise. This way we are keeping the background moody and atmospheric while drawing attention to the person standing on the cliff. One more curves effect, this time darkening the overall image a bit. Now let's get to the main part, adding sun rays to the image. Before I started editing, I searched online for some copyright-free images of sun rays that I could use. I wanted something clean with minimal background distractions, and after a bit of browsing, I found a perfect one on pexels.com. It's a shot of sun rays beaming from a glass window inside a church, which works great for this purpose. I will include the link in the video description if you want to check it out. This random image is more than enough for what we are going for. I made a few quick edits to it, starting by converting it to black and white. Then I played around the color options to find the one that gives the best contrast. After that, I used curves tool to enhance the contrast even more, turning the darker areas into pure black so the sun rays stand out better. Once that's done, I saved the image. This step ensures the sun rays will blend nicely when we add them to our main image. Now, coming back to our main edit, it's time to bring in the sun rays we just saved. I will do this using the double exposure tool. First, I'll import the image with the sun rays, then resize and position it so the rays fall exactly where I want them, mainly on and around the subject to create the dramatic lighting effect. I'll experiment with a few blending styles to see what works best for this scene and settle on the add mode, which seems to give the right feel. To make the effect more natural, I'll lower the opacity a bit so the rays don't come across too harsh. Once that's applied, I will head over to the masking screen and clean up any distractions, particularly around the bottom right corner. This already looks so much better. I'll also use the masking brush with a lower opacity to slightly remove some of the rays directly on the subject, adding just a hint of shadow to give him a more grounded and realistic feel in the scene. It's subtle, but it makes a difference. Now it's time to get the image a bit more depth and take it to next level with some minute touches and make it a bit more captivating. We are going to start by adjusting the temperature in the white balance menu. I will add some warmth to the image, which will help create a cozy sun-kissed vibe, perfect for the look we are aiming for. Next, I will introduce a bit of tint to shift the color balance and give the image that beautiful golden hour feel, as if the scene is bathed in the soft glow of evening light. These small adjustments will enhance the overall mood and tie everything together, making the image feel more polished and atmospheric. Next, I'm going to add a bit more contrast using the curves tool. I'll return to the double exposure tool a bit to fine tune the masking a little more. There's this distracting line that needs to be removed, so I'll carefully clean that up to keep the focus where it belongs. Going back to the curves tool and make further adjustments, this time focusing specifically on the subject. By adding contrast just to the subject, I can make him stand out even more against the ambient background, giving the image a balanced yet dynamic feel. Whenever you add sun rays to an image, there's naturally going to be some extra light where the rays hit. To address this, I will use the curves tool to brighten the areas where the sun rays are falling, enhancing that glowing effect. Then I will head over to the masking screen and zoom in to work on the details. I'll carefully brush over the parts where the sun rays are hitting, making sure to blend the effect smoothly. This step helps to refine the highlights and ensures they look more integrated with the rest of the image. Additionally, I will focus on the subject itself, adding a subtle rim light effect around him. This will enhance the outline of the subject, creating a natural glow that makes him stand out against the background. It's these small detailed adjustments that really make a difference and help the entire scene look more natural. For the overall look, I'm going to darken the image just a bit to give it a more dramatic and moody feel. This will help the sun rays and other effects stand out more, creating a more balanced composition. However, I'll be careful to exclude the edges of the subject from this darkening effect. I want to retain some of the light around the subject to keep him well defined and naturally illuminated. I will adjust this in the masking screen, making sure the edges of the subject stay bright and clearly visible. This way, the overall effect will be enhanced, but the subject will stand out in a way that looks more authentic. Next, I'm going to enhance the effect by creating a brighter beam at the top right edge in the direction of the light source. I will use the curves tool to significantly increase the brightness in that area, which will help simulate the intense light coming from the sun rays. In the masking screen, I'll focus on the top right edge of the image where the light would naturally be strongest. I'll carefully apply this added brightness to that specific area, ensuring it blends seamlessly with the rest of the scene. This adjustment will create a striking highlight that reinforces the light source direction and adds a final touch of realism and drama to the overall composition. Next, I will brighten the overall image using the Tune Image menu. After that, I will move on to applying some color grading using the Curves tool to give the image a more cinematic feel. In the Curves tool, I will use the blue curve. By dragging the lower point upwards, I will add more blues to the shadows, which enhances the depth and cools down the darker areas. Then I will add a touch of warmth to the highlights by dragging the upper point downwards, which introduces subtle yellows to the image. This combination of cool shadows and warm highlights creates a classic cinematic look, adding a stylish and aesthetic color tone that really brings the scene to life. It's always a good idea to revisit your work and make few final adjustments if needed to ensure everything looks just right. Hope you found the video useful and subscribe for more. See you all in my next video soon. Thanks for watching.